chain on it. Yeah, I got hearts.
So guys, we are on our way to a hotel called Melia Sky Bar. I think actually the hotel's called Melia Sky and they're having a rooftop party. So we're doing that. The housemates, we are looking good, we are feeling good. And the sleigh is real. It's a nice day, not too hot. Look at my outfit. This is from a Sky Day. It was part of my clothing haul. In her white bikini. Guys, she's single and ready to mingle. And what's your Instagram? We're gonna get your husband. Go on, plug yourself.
We'll tag it here below.
Yeah, over here below. Good morning, world. So it is Sunday. Yesterday was that epic pool party. And I had a date last night. It was literally like the worst fucking day I've had in a very long time. I might do a story time on it. That was some real shit. But I am ready. I'm about to go to church. I am late, but casually just chilling here vlogging. Good morning, world. So today I woke up with such heavy hearts. The attacks in Barcelona happened last night. I think I was just in such a state of panic and like fear of really what was happening. Okay, they've opened Plaza Real, that was all cordoned off yesterday. I literally live like 1 minute away from the Rambla. Everything is blocked, police everywhere, we're searching for people, but it looks like it is business as usual today. Today's been such a weird day because yesterday was the attack in Barcelona, La Rambla, and like literally I live 1 minute walk away from La Rambla and I'm on that street literally all the time. A different day, a different hour, I could have been one of the casualties, and I'm so thankful to God. But the city today has just been a bit weird, like people are scared to go out, like the roads are empty, tourists are staying in, you know, the discussion is just not very nice today. And like, I think a lot of people have had very heavy hearts, I know I certainly have. So I don't know, like I really don't know what to say apart from my thoughts and prayers are with all those affected. I hope you find the strength to move through this, move past this, and to the people that keep committing such hateful atrocities, you are not going to heaven. Like, what is waiting in store for you, boy? You do not want to know. Like, hate will not win, people. Just always remember that. Hate will not win. I don't want to start preaching or anything like that, but it's been a weird day. I haven't vlogged in ages either, but my projector came and that kind of cheered me up a little bit. I'm gonna film my apartment tour for you guys this weekend. You can't really see much, but make sure you guys check that out. If you've not checked it out already, it will be live before this video will be live. But thank you so much, by the way, to everyone who reached out to me. Like, I can't even believe the amount of my subscribers that have Instagrammed me just saying like the minute they heard about it their thoughts went to me and they just wanted to make sure I'm okay. Like, you guys are the sweetest. Wow, like I'm so touched, I'm so grateful, I'm doing okay, and I'm really prayerful and really grateful right now to God. So yeah, only God, you know, it's only God. So guys, this is actually like the first time I'm walking down the Rambla since like the tragedy that happened in Barcelona. One thing that I do like a lot is that people kind of just got on with it and they didn't really let it affect them. I thought like people would avoid this place. But everyone's like, you know, paying homage to the people that we lost but not really letting the fear get to them, which I think is awesome. It's busy, busy, busy. I wouldn't say it's as busy as it used to be, but yeah, it's pretty damn lost. I don't know. What is this? It's just so beautiful. I mean, you just don't think of this kind of tragedy happening so close to you. And I just feel so thankful that I didn't lose anybody that I loved. I didn't lose any friends. And I say a little prayer for the people that did. A lot of people did. So yeah, hope you guys are praying for Barcelona. So guys, I've just got back from my little shopping trip. I bought a few t-shirts, which I'm happy about. They're just like plain white, but I just need to get like a print on it. I want to get one that says "Just Doing Me, Hey," and I want to see another one that get another one that says "Looking Good, Feeling Good." So I'm back home. I'm just gonna have a look at my analytics and do some work on my YouTube channel. But I'm so excited about Madrid. I'm feeling much better. I've still got a little bit of a cold left, but it's almost gone. And yeah, it's gonna be a good trip. I literally went to 5 different shirt printing shops to get this done. This is like first models, so I'm gonna play around a little bit with the art. But yeah, I finally got my Looking Good, Feeling Good t-shirt, and I'm Just Doing Me one. So these will be coming soon, guys. If you guys are interested in having a Looking Good, Feeling Good shirt, let me know. Reach out via Instagram. And I also spent the day getting my henna done. I've got to wait like 3 more hours before I can scrape it off, but how good does that look? I've not finished packing for Madrid and I'm absolutely shattered. So I'm gonna try and finish up now and have an early night because I've got an early flight in the morning. So I'm at the airport and I made it in good time for once in my life. Well, actually, I'm saying that a little bit too soon. I'm heading to my gate. Madrid, here I come. So my sister's gonna be meeting me there. She says she's already on her way to the airport as well. She's flying there from England. You guys know my sister is my fave travel buddy. Yes. Yes, this is what I saw when I looked online and I was like, it's a bit far out of the center, but I have to stay here. How nice is this? It's like a little hidden garden away. Hey.
Hey guys.
So we finally made it to Madrid. A few hours ago, we're heading out for the first time. And just like hit the town, have a few drinks, just discover Madrid, see if they're feeling the melanin, if they like a bit of chocolate.
So we're tucking into the food.
Looks good, doesn't it? Guys, I'm so happy to be here. I can't believe I'm turning 28 in 3 days. But I don't look it, do I? I feel like I can pass for like 22.
No,
is that, I can't. You said I can't pass for 22? What? Shade. Wait. Why can't I pass for 22?
Because you look like you're 23.
I can't even for 23. That's alright. I look like I'm 23. Okay. I thought you were trying to shade the life out of me. 23? Not bad at all.
Because of people,
Here in Barcelona. It's really fun actually meeting all of you guys, so thanks for reaching out. Nettie's goodies. So today was my birthday. It's just gone midnight though, so it's no longer my birthday. I had a super chill day. I didn't really want to go out, but I know you've come all the way from America, so like I wasn't gonna let you down because you've been like, you reached out to me months back now. So I'm just gonna go say hello, have a few drinks, put some eyebrows on and put some lip gloss on. That's about all we're doing. But yeah, hey girl, love you guys. Good morning world. So today we've got like kind of like our end of year and a financial year work party. It's called the summer camp, and it's basically like this beach party. They've hired out a private beach, so it's going to be epic. I really don't normally wear makeup to work, but today we made an exception. So we're looking good, we're feeling good. I'm hoping today's gonna be fun.
Tears in this.
I'm gonna go kayaking. Check that out. Get on the kayaks, the jet skis. Hashtag HPE know how to throw a party. Just in my gin and tonic. Minding my own business. Just dropped my straw.
I was in the pool, the beach, I was in the sea, and it was kind of epic. And we're just back, and everybody's just like, bye. I had such a good time. Hey! Say hello! I've had the best time.
I know, right?
It was so much fun. Why can't we do this every week?
I said, I don't even.
Hey,
It's a video!
So we've just gotten changed for the evening and it's like a neon themed party. But I've just like stuck lots of neon on me. I'm not actually wearing neon. But yeah, everyone's looking good. Let's do this. Hey! This is my weird team doing the maze. Look who wants to be on my YouTube. It's not a picture, it's a video, guys. No. Say hi.
It's a video.
It's a video.
Okay. Do we have to say something?
Yeah, say something cool.
Something cool?
Something cool.
My socks.
No. That's a no.
How are you?
I'm good, how are you? That you splashed me earlier. I know. Payback is coming. How epic is this? Oh my god. So I snogged this guy that I have fancied since I started my job at HPE. Like, I've literally fancied him the entire time I've worked there. And today I snogged him. Is that bad? Where the fuck? Okay, there it is. He just came and he sat next to me and he was flirting with me earlier in the day. And he sat next to me today and he was like, I don't know. I just feel like I shouldn't have done it because on Monday I'm gonna see him and I'm totally gonna pretend like I fucking don't know him. That's just like the way I bloody roll. I'm gonna pretend like I don't know him. So should I actually have done it, especially when I'm dating friends? Oh, but honestly, it feels so good because I fancied him for the longest and it just feels good knowing that I can have him if I want him. But I don't think I should want him because I like what me and Fran have. Yeah. Mimi, you bad girl!